Located about 150 kilometres southwest of Austria's capital Vienna is Technik Point, a performance workshop that also runs a race prep and track support division called Race Rent. We visited Technik Point to check out the facility, the cars, and to chat with the owner, a man named Wolfgang. Unfortunately, we don't speak any German, and Wolfgang doesn't speak any English. However, Thomas, the man who runs Haltech Europe, speaks both and was more than happy to help us out. The workshop is chock-a-block full of rally, hill climb and circuit cars. From the tried and proven Evos to custom-built prototype class races and rally classics like this soon-to-be-completed replica Audi S1 Quattro, which we cannot wait to see compete as the quality of this particular build is stunning.
Wolfgang, kannst du uns ein bisschen was über deine Firma erzählen? Wann wurde sie gegründet und was macht ihr im Detail?
Ja, nachdem ich seit über 20 Jahren selber auch Motorsport betreibe, habe ich mich 2007 dazu entschlossen, das Hobby eigentlich zum Beruf zu machen. Habe meine Firma gegründet. Unser Hauptaugenmerk am Anfang war die Vermietung von Rallye-Fahrzeugen. Wir haben damals mit einem Fahrzeug angefangen, haben jetzt 8 Stück zu vermieten.
This white Focus Shell will eventually be a new proto car. Introduced last year to the Austrian Championships, the Proto, also called Open N Class, allows either a Subaru or Mitsubishi drivetrain to be reskinned with any modern car shell. This Focus body will end up mated to an Evo 9 engine drivetrain combo.
Sind dann vor 4 Jahren zum Entschluss gekommen, dass wir eine neue Firma bauen, weil wir platzmäßig natürlich eingeengt waren, haben den Standort gewechselt, neu gebaut, einige Neukunden natürlich dazu bekommen. Auf den Fahrzeugen arbeiten wir natürlich ständig. So wie im Hintergrund der Mitsubishi ist auch ein Kundenfahrzeug.
Race Rent's customers are certainly looked after, with Wolfgang and the crew taking care of all the logistics. The driver only needs to turn up to the track and race.
Ja, setzen diese, wenn wir bei den Rallye sind, ein und betreuen sie vor Ort, nehmen sie wieder mit nach Hause und revidieren die bis zur nächsten Veranstaltung und ja.
Wolfgang, welchen Motorsport hast du eigentlich am liebsten?
Ja, das ist unumstritten nach wie vor seit über 20 Jahren Rallye. Ist für mich mit nichts zu vergleichen. Nicht mit Slalom, nicht mit Berg, nicht mit Rundstrecke.
When not building, fixing or preparing race cars, Wolfgang likes to do a bit of racing himself. His weapon of choice, a seriously modified Mitsubishi Colt. And trust us, when we say seriously modified, we mean it. The base car is a late 1990s Mitsubishi Colt, also known as a Mirage in some countries. It has been turned from a budget runaround to a capable circuit and hill climb race car. While the main section of the monocoque remains steel, major weight savings have been achieved by replacing the roof, bonnet, front fenders, bumpers and the doors with carbon fibre substitutes. Power to weight ratio is of course a priority for a competitive race car, but it's only part of the overall equation.
First of all, the power to weight ratio, then the suspension, aerodynamics, tires, movability, everything must fit together. The car is underestimated. Nobody will think about that this car has 800 horsepower. I can tell you, I already had a ride. It flies like a plane.
So, how does this Colt make its 800 horsepower? That's thanks to its all-wheel drive running gear, which has been lifted straight from an Evo 7. The famous 4G63 4-banger has been stroked to 2.3 litres and uses Garrett's GT35 turbo, producing 2.9 bar of boost. Wolfgang runs 2 injectors per cylinder, MSG direct fire coils, and a custom drive-by-wire setup which has been installed to improve drivability and allow for more aggressive anti-lag settings. To ensure oil supply in high-speed corners, a larger oil pan has been fitted, complete with a system of baffles and chambers. The oil capacity is now a massive 8 litres.
the engine is controlled by an Elite 1500 ECU. We have different boost levels per gear. The flat shift function is activated for the sequential gear shifts. We have different stages of anti-lag, and also launch control is implemented.
In addition to the standard set of sensors, Thomas, who is responsible for keeping the car in tune, has also added a set of EGTs with a TCA4 box for individual cylinder tuning. A Trick Tibbuk intake manifold with individual throttle bodies is connected to an in-cabin control unit, which allows Wolfgang to adjust the anti-lag settings on the fly. Oh yeah, there are flames. The CAPS transmission can be shifted with either a lever or the steering-mounted paddle shifter. When asked about traction control, Thomas said, "There isn't any. Wolfgang prefers to have the option to lose traction if he wants to, because Wolfgang is our kind of guy." Most of the fuel system, including the tanks and the two Bosch 044 pumps that supply the E85 fuel to the engine, live in the boot.
Hilton braces are run on public roads. There is no room for errors. There is a nice scenery in the mountains, and it's very challenging for every driver, and it places huge demand on the driver and the machine.
So, after visiting a few local workshops, it dawned on us that the Austrians are particularly keen on any racing that involves tight corners, be it rally, circuit, or in particular, hill climb. They also seem to instinctively know how to build cars to compete at those events rather well. And that's something that we can appreciate even without knowing the language.
Mm-hmm.